want to teach people to believe in themselves the way Kanye believes in himself. Everybody on this planet believed in themselves the way Kanye believed in themselves, we'd be so much further ahead. And I think the first way to start that is to stop hating everything. Like, everything doesn't suck. Maybe some shit's just not for you.
How you feel about it? Nothing's real about it. Man, these rappers can't rap. As soon as you ask them to rap, they gon' pull out their phone and look back at they pack like a tack. What the fuck they about?
Towards the end of the tour, I wanna say like the last four dates of the tour ended up getting canceled because on the East Coast, the weather was crazy. I don't know what was going on, but it was just all snow.
It just got so cold. The snow came in so thick, we had to cancel like a gang of dates.
We ended up just parking the tour bus
at the hotel. Left it there, turned on the 2K, made sure the heat and everything worked, made sure the studio worked.
And getting to work, you know.
Banged out the project that is the Good Vibe Tribe.
I need the James Brown light right quick. Roger Troutman to write my shit. A hemp wick to ignite my spliff. And some college girls to come supply my fix. Cause I heard through the grapevine. They take time in the mirror to stay fine. Study in daytime. Nighttime is playtime. Say she love to play shine at break time. Well, that means you know me. Let's have a great time. I'ma sing.
I mean, it's crazy how... It's just crazy how life works and the creator like works in your favor when things are meant to be. Because if you wouldn't have got those 4 days or like however many days it was to just sit there and work, we wouldn't have got as much of the Good Vibe Tribe done as fast as we did as far as skits. Like people don't know like,
how we do a lot of the recording that we go and do. Like, we create the whole environment, from the beach to the people, every piece.
Like, we handcrafted each skit on this project. Personally, had every person come in, added each effect.
So having the different voices and the different people there that came and participated with us, man.
And it was dope because of the energy on there. Like, it just feels incredible creating music on the tour bus, like in the middle of snow, and just it's just crazy. You know, sick. Every single thing about the project from top to bottom, we handcrafted, so we got a lot of time to do that on the bus.
That was probably the best feeling, man, seeing it all translate exactly how I wanted it to, and how Price wanted it to, and how us just as a collective really wanted it to. It's refreshing and it's dope. I hate the fact that no albums are cohesive. Except for like Kendrick, like that have like a real story from start to finish, where like you can't start at the middle because you'll miss a piece of the real story. Since Come As You Are, we've really been like making sure from front to back you have a whole concept. So putting every skit and everything in there, it's just, we're very particular about that. A lot of the posts at the end of the whole project is that it's all skits, not even really necessarily the songs and stuff. Skits is really like the heart and soul of it all. It ties it all together. It's the glue. God put it together, man. It's just vibes. It's all vibes. That's what I love about the project. The fact that when I listen to it, even back now, I know like how those songs came together, and it's really like real people having real conversation. Just on a microphone.
Right now it's freezing. We're working. Nigga, record, write, engineer, perform. We do it all.
None of it was really too scripty, so it's amazing. I still don't know.
I don't want nobody else. I just want you.